Hey guys, it's Alyssa. So today I'm going to be going through basically all of my photographic work from the last year and a half or so, basically three semesters. I'm currently going into my final semester of senior year, so that's pretty crazy, but yeah, this is what I've been working on. So I think basically the way I'm gonna format this video, I'm gonna show you the photographs for like each series. Plus, most of them I wrote out like an explanation that either preceded or went at the end of the photos, like when they were viewed, because all of these things have been printed. Yeah, I think they've all been printed and presented in like a class format for critique. So yeah, I'll let y'all see it basically as people saw it, except technically they saw it in person. But yeah, and then I will sort of explain what I did. I'm not gonna spend quite so much time focusing on like the technicalities, so like how I took the photos or like the equipment I used. But if there's anything that you would like to know what I used, feel free to comment down below and I will definitely get back to you on that. But yeah, let's get started. So, also if I'm looking down, I have everything pulled up on my laptop so that I know what I'm talking about, so. So starting with, this is, I guess, a year and a half ago now, basically. So this was the first semester of my junior year. Yeah, and this project was called Welcome to Texas, so now I'll let y'all look at it. So actually this project I did a whole other video on, which I will have somewhere up on the screen if you would like to go more in depth with this particular project. I basically talked about the whole process from coming up with the concept to the very end. But yeah, I was pretty happy with this one and I have a physical copy to show y'all. This was, oh, this is hard to show. Sorry about the reflections, but this is for like scale, I guess, basically just to show y'all. And then this would be the other side of the street. Yeah, like I said in the little description there at the end, the purpose of the series was to basically talk about, particularly in Texas, how we have all this extra space to keep building new things, particularly buildings, ignoring what still exists and is usable. And I think that sort of talks about just, in general, consumerism. Something sort of unique to this project, I guess. I went into it thinking I was shooting landscapes because, you know, everything was shot in landscape and it was buildings, no people. And the other option was portrait for this project. This was advanced photo, but we still had a little more guidance at this time. So, yeah, but as I went along, I realized it was really a portrait of Texas, basically. So, I ended up switching over from landscape to portrait. So I think this project of all of them is probably my favorite in terms of how it was printed. I basically used these metal sheets. I ordered this from MPix, did not do this myself. And it comes with this like nice back mount so you could easily hang it. But I chose to use this more like reflective metal plate because I feel like it really does give the light sort of luminance, I guess. But yeah, this is, again, size reference. And I guess something like, I feel like at this point, when I was making my photographic work or whatever, a lot of it involves like two sides, and you can even see that in the last project, but obviously there's the first layer of wondering what's going on inside the houses. It's kind of eerie because it's dark, but then there's this bright light. But then on the other hand, there is also the representation of the human body being the buildings, and then like us not knowing what's going on inside of the houses or the other people's minds. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like I said, it's a lot more eloquent in what I wrote, but the light serving as an allusion to the innermost thoughts, feelings, and desires each person has, yet others can never really understand. That states it a lot better. Most of the time I set up my photos in, I don't know exactly what it's called, like a gallery style, where you like just walk across and they're each in a line or whatever, but this one I went more salon style, where you sort of fit the pieces together in a way that you think gets the concept across the best, and I felt like this project lended itself well to that setup, as you can see in the installation view. Okay, and then this is the last project that I did for that first class that I'm going over, basically. And this was actually shot on film, and then I used Photoshop to put the words over the top. I called this project 21, and which is how old I was when I was making the project. And it was under the category of document, so I was documenting my friends at a certain period of time. But it also was kind of meant to act more as a self-portrait of myself, but using people that I knew at age 21. And when I set this up, and I guess the order that you saw this too, it's in the order that I met the people. And what's interesting is, like, I think I said this in the statement, like 5 to 10 years from now, like, I might not have the same setup of people, so it's, I don't have the same influences. And then I also, so I shot them in the woods because I sort of think of that, well, for one, it was consistency, but also it's sort of like memories of childhood and youth. So the stories that each person wrote ties to some memory of their childhood. And that sort of, again, is talking about like how your experiences as a kid like influence who you are. And then like the people you know are also influenced by like your past, if that makes sense, how it's all sort of just intertwined and connected. And I also think of nature as being sort of like an elemental stage that kind of connects us all in a way. So that was the like gist of that, I guess. Now we're moving into second semester junior year. Now, as you know, COVID was a thing. So this first project kind of had two parts. So it counted as like project one and two. Thank you. I have the actual little printout. This thing was a pain to get done. Basically, to make this make a little more sense, so the prints you saw, that's like the comparisons, and that was the first part of the project, just to come up with the concept and do the prints. Second part of the project was to convert it into an alternative structure, but this time it was all books. So I'll show you just like a spread to give you an idea. So here's one spread, and like when you first look at it, it's just like a double page spread basically. But then this side, the flap opens, and on here, so this gave the name of the chemical plus like an explanation about it. And like for this one, formaldehyde was the common chemical, and from my research, one cigarette had the same amount of formaldehyde as four of these little scented trees. And then on this side, I have the health risks of formaldehyde. So basically the point of this was to compare how there's all these objects that like we automatically associate like dangers with, but then there's also all these objects that we use every day that we aren't aware that they have health hazards, but they have the exact same like component that makes one bad. I feel like this project, out of everything that I'm showing today, it strays away from like my style, I guess, and like the general, I don't know, I guess narrative that I try to tell. But this one actually had some personal meaning, and I'm glad I did it. But yeah, I do feel like it's a little bit out there from everything else that I'm showing y'all. Okay, so this next project, actually, so when we came home in March for, because of the virus, we got sent home. So this was part of just like a random, basically every day we had to shoot, I think it was like, yeah, 12 photos a day, or 12 photos 5 days a week for 3 weeks. And then I took my favorite ones and sort of made my own little thing over the summer, and I wanted to share it because I like the project a lot. So again, even the statement's a little bit more rough because I pretty much just posted on Instagram. Unfortunately, don't have any of the physical prints with me, but I did actually print them, and I just sold them on my Instagram. I still have some, they're just not in this location, they're back at school. But yeah, if you do have any interest in buying any of these, I do already have pre-made prints of them. I did do a couple other things for that class, but that's pretty much all I wanted to show for that one, because like I said, the rest of it was online. Yeah, so this is my last class. This was probably one of my favorite classes. It was an independent study, but it was basically my medium large format class. They just weren't offering it this past semester, so I did it as more of a one-on-one thing. But this first project was done in large format, so I don't know what the name of the camera was, but it was one of those, you know, big ones that stretches out and has, you know, like bellows, and you do all the like shifting and tilting and all that stuff. But yeah, so this is what one of the darkroom prints turned out. So this is not a digital print. I did this in the darkroom. but yeah, I really like how this one turned out. Okay, and this one I don't have a statement for, but basically I was thinking about like our ties between like memories and objects. So especially thinking about how like we didn't really get to travel much this year, which my family usually does quite a bit of traveling every summer. I was thinking about how like we want so badly to hold on to experiences, and so we use like photographs and like souvenir objects and whatnot. And it was, again, this wasn't a super deep one, but I thought the images turned out like pretty nice. Okay, and then this was my second project of this class. This one was shot with the Pentax 6.7 and it was Portra 400 for the film.
I'm not perfect. I can't see anything that I don't like about you.
So I shot all of these at either sunrise or sunset, which gives them a very like muted tone to them, which could in some sense make them feel kind of isolated, but also I feel like there is an amount of peace that comes with these places. I've always thought that like blue hour especially feels like a very peaceful time, even though it could also be read as sort of eerie. And so that's what I was kind of thinking about with these images. I felt like the time of day that it was shot was just as important as the locations used. And then this is the final project I'm going to be going over, and this one was also shot on the same Pentax 6.7 but with the Ilford HP5 400 speed film. This one, I feel like, was the most organic as far as the concept goes. I kind of just went out and started shooting because I didn't know what I wanted to do, really. But I also wanted to try and make something out of things that I would naturally shoot rather than like coming up with a concept beforehand, I guess. And yeah, in the end, I thought a little bit about the decisive moment, which is basically the idea that the photographer captures the world when everything seemingly falls into place. And I feel like that comes across fairly well in most of these photos. And also what's interesting about them is like, there aren't any, like there's no human presence, but you also can feel that there's a human presence based off of like objects and like the windows and that one with the stairs being open, like you know that there's people around but like there aren't, and there's, I don't know, there's something kind of cool about that. The idea of like in a very like cold, because these are all very like concrete areas, like literally because of the structures, but they also feel like less cold because there's these little bits of warmth basically throughout. Yeah, so that's basically all I wanted to say about these, I think. Hopefully this wasn't too much reading. I didn't want to just like straight up read the concepts out to y'all because I feel like y'all can read and it's probably faster that way, I don't know. But if y'all don't want me to do videos like that in the future, feel free to let me know. Always open to constructive criticism. Yeah, like I said at the beginning of this video, if you have any questions, feel free to let me know. Also, if you want to see more of my photography work, my Instagram is at vinyl.flower. That's my photo Instagram. I'll have like my personal one linked and everything as well. Also, unrelated to photo, I'm starting to sell some other art on Etsy. Shameless self-promo, I guess, but if you have any interest in looking at that. So far I only have some block print stuff, but I'm working on some paintings that'll also be going up sometime soon. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this and that this was helpful in some way or just enjoyable to watch. And stay tuned for more videos. Bye.